Hello, nice to see you again. I say glad tidings to you. I bring good news all the way from Galatians back to you. So I want to say, how are you all doing? And I believe the Lord is good, as He is good to me too. So I bring to you all the way from Galatians the good news once again of our Lord Jesus Christ. So I am here to say, welcome back again. So I have something to tell you. I have something important to tell you. According to what I hear from God, I was praying in Galatians. I was praying, and God opened my eyes about Nigeria again. About Nigeria. I was with my wife. We are praying for Nigeria. We are praying for the whole world, and the Lord spoke to me. He revealed something about Nigeria coming election to me, which I want to share right now with you. I want to let you know the intent of God's heart, what is in the heart of God concerning Nigeria and concerning the people of Nigeria and the whole world at large. Okay, I will be guiding you now concerning what I hear from the Lord. God said to me, if you people vote Atiku to be your president, that you people should expect part two of what you people experienced in the hand of Buhari. God said to me, there is no difference. That Atiku and Buhari is the same. It's nothing but the same. That part two is going to be more dangerous, more deadly. You are crying for the bloodshed in Nigeria. You are crying for the poverty, for the hunger. God said, if you vote in Atiku, expect part two. And part two is going to be worse. It's going to be poor. It's going to be worse than part one. So I will guide you right now. I will guide you into all truth. I will tell you the truth according to what God said. Because when I'm talking based on the authority that God gave to me. I am not speaking under my own authority. I'm talking because God said to me to talk. God speak to me and said, speak. So I don't have choice than to speak. So I will be guiding you right now through the word of God, what God said. Article, as I said to you, is coming to spread thick darkness in Nigeria. It's coming to spread, it's to spread more poverty, more hunger. It's going to be deadly. It's going to be bloody. It's going to be darkness. It's going to be disastrous. His coming is not for good. Is the continuation of the suffering you experience in the hand of Buhari. So I will guide you right now in the word of God according to what God said. I don't want to do the talking. I don't want to do the talking now. Let the word of God do the talking. So I want to show you something in the book of Ezekiel, chapter 21. I will be reading it and I will explain it to you. Because I have told you and I will not change my mind. The only person that I see heaven choose is AAC. I don't care. People said it is not a Christian, it's not a believer, is this, is that. I can't change my mind or change my word. The only person that heaven have chosen as of now, as I'm doing this video, as I'm talking to you, is Mr. Chole of AAC. I keep saying it. I can't change it because God said it to me, and final, I don't want to say my own. Now, I want to guide you. For you that is jumping up article as your Messiah again, the same way you jump for Buhari when he's coming. You don't know that you're welcoming what we know disaster, what will come and suck your blood, what will come and destroy you. You are jumping up and down the time that you people voted him in. Now, article appeared. You people can easily forget. God said to me, if you people try to vote in Atiku, you are your own, at your own risk. Whatever thing that you see, don't complain, don't cry. So listen very careful. I'm going now into the word of God to show you what God said about about Atiku knocking at the door. Knocking at the door. There is nothing good coming from him. Listen now in the book of Ezekiel, chapter 21, from verse 1. And the word of the Lord came to me, and the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, set your face towards Jerusalem. preach against the holy places and prophesy against the land of Israel. And he said to the land of Israel, thus, and he said to the land of Nigeria, because you have to be wise to understand the word of God. You have to be very, very wise for you to understand the word of God. And he said to the land of Nigeria, here is Israel, thus says the Lord, behold, I am against you, and I will draw my sword out of its sheath, and cut off both righteous and the wicked from you. The anger of God. God is talking about cutting off the wicked and the righteous. Who are the righteous he's talking about? It's not the righteous one that is in Christ. It's the self-righteous ones. Self-righteous ones. Those that believe their pastor more than God, more than the word of God. Those that is fighting for their pastor, that is leading you astray, telling you to vote for a man that will come and drink your blood that time. God is talking about these pastors. Because your pastor have collected, go and reconcile article, collected how many million are you there for? You know, they consigned and now his campaign, you know, campaigning for him and all that. They will not tell you the truth because all that they're after is their own pocket, their own purse. Then they will take the money and deceive all of you. And during their campaign, they will come to you and say, oh, we're going to do this and that. They will deal with you people. They will deal with people, vote in article and see what happened. The same way I told you about Buhari, I'm telling you now what God said about article. Listen very careful. Because Oyedepo and all of them that is deceiving you people, they are on it again. They are on the business again. But this time around, I am telling the truth. Listen. God said, and said to the land of, if you vote in article, I'm just telling for you what will happen to you. And said to the land of Israel, Thus said the Lord, behold, I'm against you, and I will draw my sword out of its sheath and cut off both righteous and wicked from you. Because I will cut off both righteous and wicked from you. Therefore, my sword shall go out of its sheath against all flesh from south to north, that all flesh may know that I, the Lord, have drawn my sword out of its sheath. It shall not return anymore. Sigh, therefore, son of man, with a breaking heart, and sigh with bitterness before their eyes. And it shall be when they say to you, why are you sighing, that you shall answer, because of the news I've heard, because of the news. When it comes, every heart will melt, all hands will be feeble, every spirit will faint, and all knees will be weak as water. Behold, it is coming, and it shall be brought to pass, says the Lord God. Again, the word of the Lord came to me, saying, son of man, prophesy and say, thus says the Lord, say, a sword is sharpened, and also polished, sharpened to make a dreadful slaughter, polished to flash like lightning. Should we then make met? It despises the scepter of my son, as it does all wood. And he has given it to be polished, that it may be handled. This sword is sharpened and it is polished, to be given into the hand of the slayer. Cry and wail, son of man, for it will be against my people. It will be against my people. Against my people. Against all the princes of Israel. This time around, your pastors. Your pastors, they will drink their blood. They will cut off your pastors. They will deal with them. Not only the believers. The article, as I said to you, is coming. If you people say that he's your Messiah, he's coming to cut off your pastor's head. Cut off your own head. They are coming to deal with you people mercilessly. I am telling you the truth. But if you have ear, listen and let people know. Say, cry and wail, son of man, for it will be against my people, against all the priests of Israel. Terror, including the sword, will be against my people. Therefore, strike your thigh. Because it is a testing, and what if the sword despises even the scepter shall be no more. Says the Lord God. You therefore, son of man, prophesy and strike your hands together the third time. Let the sword do double damage. I said the part two. Part two is going to be more deadly than part one under Buhari. Part two in the end of article will be more deadly than the part one of Buhari. It is the sword that slays. The sword that slays the great men. Your great men, your pastors. Your great men, they should get ready. That enters their private chambers. I have set the point of the sword against all their gates, that the heart may melt and many may stumble. Ah, it is made bright. It is grass for slaughter. Sword at the ready. Thrust right. Set your blade. Thrust left. Wherever your edge is ordered. I also will beat my fist together. And I will cause my fury to rest. I, the Lord, have spoken. The sword of the Lord came to me. Sorry. The word of the Lord came to me. Yeah, the sword of God is his word. The word of the Lord came to me again, saying, and the son of man, appoint for yourself two ways for the sword of the king of Babylon to go. They are the Babylonians. If you don't know, the northerners, they are the Babylonians. So if you choose them again, this is what will happen. And the son of man, appoint for yourself two ways for the sword of the king of Babylon to go. Both of them shall go from the same land, from the same north. Make a sign. Put it at the head of the road. Put it at the head of the road to the city. Appoint a road for the sword to go to the Rabbah of the Ammonites and to Judah into fortified Jerusalem. Church. They are targeting church seriously. This time is their target is their pastor. Their pastor has collected millions of dollars from them and prophesy that they are the Messiah. They are the one. As they are slaughtering the Christians, the fake Christians, they also will handle the leader, the head, the pastors. This is what I'm trying to read for you to understand very clear. Appoint a road for the sword to go to Rabbah of the Ammonites and to Judah into fortified Jerusalem. For the king of Babylon stands at the pattern of the road, at the fork of the two roads, to use divination. He shakes the arrows. He consults the image. He looks at the giver. In his right hand is divination for Jerusalem, for church. To set up battering rams, to call for a slaughter, to lift the voice with shouting, to set battering rams against the gates, to heap up a siege mound and to build a wall. And it will be to them like a false divination in the eyes of those who have sworn oath with them. Your pastors that have sworn oath to them, they will think they are together with them. They don't know that. You can't know the heart of Hausas. The Muslim, whatever thing they plan, you can't know it. Their heart is deep. You can't understand, know it. Whatever they decide to do, you can't know it. And they will heed it until the time to bring it out. So know this very well. And it will be to the fake pastors, to the fake believers, like believing their pastors, that they are fake pastors. And it will be to them like a false divination in the eyes of those who have sworn oath with them. But he will bring their iniquity to remembrance, that they may be taken. He will tell them all their secrets that they are doing together, that they are not serving the Most High, that they are not from God Almighty. Therefore, thus says the Lord God, because you have made your iniquity to be remembered, in that your transgressions are uncovered, so that in all your doings, your sins appear. The sin is great. Your sins appear. because you have come to remembrance, you shall be taken in hand. Now to you, O profane, wicked prince of Israel. God is talking to your pastors, wicked prince of Israel, whose days has come, whose iniquity shall end. Thus says the Lord God, remove the turban. The turban is those things they use, or the collar they put as a, I'm a holy man of God, or they put the one they put on their head to say that they are a holy man, but the inside of them, they are devil, they are bloodsuckers, they are pastors or preachers on the pit of hell, you know, they are vampires, they belong to all the occultic powers in the world, and they are coming to portray to you, I'm a holy man, touch not my anointed, and do my prophet, no harm, and all of you are running away, saying, oh, it's a holy man of God. They can deceive you, but not me. They can deceive you. They keep deceiving you, not me. They can't deceive me. They can't deceive me at all. Okay. God said, remove the turban and take. I'm reading Ezekiel 21. I'm reading verse 26 now. Thus says the Lord God, remove the turban and take off the crown. This crown on their head. Remove the turban. And say, remove the turban and take off the crown. Nothing shall remain the same. God said, nothing will remain the same again. In Nigeria, in the whole world. Enough of evil, enough of evil, enough of all this evil, enough of the evil we are seeing in the world. God said, nothing shall remain the same. Nothing shall remain the same. Exalt the humble and humble the exalted. It's time for the humble ones to be exalted. It's time for the self-exalted ones to be flushed down to pit of hell where they all belong, especially those that is lying and killing and stealing and destroying with the name of the Lord Most High. It's time right now to throw them down and to exalt the humble children of God. This is time to lift you up. Nothing shall remain the same. Oh, nothing shall remain the same. Exalt the humble and humble the exalted. Overthrow. This is time our God is overthrowing the nations, so overthrowing all kingdoms on the face of the earth. Overthrown. I will make it overthrown. God will overthrown the evil in Nigeria. God is overthrown the evil in Nigeria, the evil in the whole world. Overthrown. I will make it overthrown. It shall be no longer until he comes, whose right it is, and I will give it to him. So this is what God said to me. God gave to me that I just read now for you to understand. God said, you choose to follow your own way or to vote to the people that your pastors have collected money from and they deceive you, tell you that this is a Messiah. As I know all of you, that your pastor is God. You don't know your word. You don't know God's word anymore. Even when you see a true man of God, a true preacher, you call him is a fake. The true man of God or true man of God now is fake. Why the fake one to you is original? I don't care, but let us know what happens. I am just telling you what he said. But you can do what you want to do. But God says, if you vote for Atiku, or you vote for Buhari, you're on your own. Part two of the killings, the hunger, part two, the poverty, part two, is what you should expect. You should expect the disaster, the destruction, the calamity that you just experienced part one in hand of Buhari. If you vote for Buhari, I mean, if you vote for APC or you vote for PDP, you're on your own. They are to continue the part two, and part two is going to be dangerous. Okay, but God is so kind. God is a God that he will in exam hall, our God is so good. He's a good God. I never said an invigilator like him. You know, God is the one that is doing your test, want to test you. But he gave you expo. Our God gives expo. Someone will say, what is time to say? What is this one trying to say? God will bring mathematics or English to test you whether you know it. But along the way, he tells you, but see the answer. Do this one. This God is love. I love him so much. I've never seen a God like him. So I want to show you what he said in the book of Deuteronomy. He don't want you to perish. God doesn't want Nigeria to perish. God loved Nigeria so much. God so much loved the world that he gave his only begotten son that whoever believe in him, believe in what he's saying, believe in the word that I just, in his word he gives to me, I'm giving to you. No, you will not perish, but have everlasting life, enjoy life. If you believe what I'm telling you and walk in the way of God that I'm guiding you now, not to a pastor that cannot guide you. If you follow it now, you will enjoy life and enjoy everlasting. But if you follow your own way, you follow your fake pastors at your own risk. I read something again for you before we close this this one. I want to read something now for you to hear. Just in this, God gave us. That's why I say that God is so good. The one that want to you know, to examine you, that want to give you exam papers, and also give you expo. I want to read something now in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse. Okay, Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 15. I read for you. The expo God gave to you. He have told you what Buhari want to, you know, is doing. And also, he have now revealed to you what article is carrying the inside that you want to come and exercise. He have revealed to you, but also he want to give you expo. He want to give you expo to vote for AAC, so that it will be well with you. He gave you expo. The three APC, PDP, AAC. He gave you expo. Listen. See, God says, see, I have set before you today. See, I have set before you today life and good, death and evil. Listen very careful. I don't know whether you have here, whether you can hear. Just listen. God is giving you a spool. He's revealed to you APC, PDP, AAC. He's giving you a spool now. He's giving you a spool. See, I have said before you today, life and good, if you people choose good, choose life, choose good. See, I have said before you today, life and good, death and evil. You want death and evil, you know the party to vote. You want life, you want life and good, you know the party to vote also. That God has said before you now, life and good, death and evil. Now, he now said here, he said, but if your heart turns away so that you do not hear, and are drawn away and worship other gods and serve them, I announce to you today that you shall surely perish. If you do not follow what he's saying, say, I announce to you today that you shall surely perish. You shall not prolong your days in the land which you cross over the Jordan to go in and possess. Because I call heaven and earth, as witnesses. Today against you, that I have set before you life and death, blessings and cursing. Therefore, choose life, the expo. Oh, come on, what a lovely God. And this is the real expo I want to give to you, what God is saying. I call heaven and earth as witnesses today against you, against the people of Nigeria, against the people of the world. And he said that I have set before you, I call heaven and earth as witnesses today against you, that I have set before you life and death, blessings and cursing. Therefore, choose life that both you and your descendants may live. You choose people that will come and drink your blood and kill your children. And what I see is that I saw a terrifying revelation where they use knife coming to people's house, using knife and slaughtering people. I saw it very clear. The killing I saw was severe. It was terrifying when God is giving me this revelation. So please, I say to you, God has spoken to you about PDP, APC, AAC, and he has given you expo. Do the right thing. I love you guys so much. I love Nigeria. I love the world. I want the best for everybody. God wants the best for you. That's why he gave his son Jesus to come to die. He came to die because he wants to show you how much he loves you. Thank you very much. God bless you. As you hear this and you try to educate other people, let them know that God has given them expo. God has set exam papers and also revealed the result. They give them the expo. Give people the expo what to do to pass the test. God bless you. Really good.